Yes, there he is.
Yeah, I can now see the much awaited face.
Let's get started.
Yeah, sure.
So this is Sharanya, isn't it?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, we're starting, sir. Yeah, we're starting. Go ahead, sir, please.
Good afternoon, Toastmasters and guests. I'm happy in welcoming you all for the 581st meeting of Medley Toastmasters Club. I'm Sharanya. I'll be playing the role of Sergeant at Arms for today's meeting. The mission of Toastmasters Club is to provide a mutually supportive and a positive learning environment in which every member gets an opportunity to improve their communication and leadership skills, which in turn fosters self-confidence and personal growth. In every Toastmasters meeting, we follow three ground rules. Rule number one is, please maintain silence throughout the meeting. If you're not talking, please go on mute. If you wanted to move around, please turn off your video. Rule number two is, please avoid taboo topics such as sex, religion, and politics. And rule number three is, in every Toastmasters meeting, each and every member is supposed to join the meeting in a formal attire. So please do join the meeting in a formal attire. With this, I would like to hand it over to the presiding officer for today's meeting. It is Toastmaster Raghunath Nair. A small introduction about him. Raghunath is working as a Deputy General Manager in Nissan Micro. And I have worked closely with him several times. And the person who takes all situations and handles them in a very calm way, this is the one that I really admire with Raghunath Nair. Over to you, Raghunath sir.
Thank you so much for that flabbergasting introduction, Sharanya. Toastmasters, guests, a warm good evening to all of you. Today, it's like got an opportunity being the presiding officer for a Medleyan, and it's really fortunate to address you as a presiding officer. The couple of points that we have, and I believe it is as a team that we need to really look into, is one, we will be having the contest for the evaluation and the humorous speech, which we will be announcing it very shortly. So whoever would like to participate in the humorous speech contest and evaluation speech contest, please get in touch with me or Thomas sir or the team under VPE. And also please, it's the team which makes the various awards that we need to win in the coming terms. So the attendance in the meetings are very important. So let's all together put in and talk to each other who are not being part of the meetings so that we get them for these meetings. And then let me have a quick discussion with the new members or the guests. Tilaga, would you like to introduce yourself as the guest, like to the Medleyans?
Hello, sir. Good afternoon. Can you hear me?
Yes, we can. Yeah.
Yes, I'm Tilaga. I hear about Toastmasters. So presently, I'm working in Nissan. So now we are taking care of a business called South Asia Business. Now, Mr. Raghu is heading the business. So I'm one of them who report to him. So I'm very glad to work with Mr. Raghu. So like yesterday he was speaking about Toastmaster Club and the role he is playing in it. So immediately our team members, we told like our interest to participate in the club. So he has invited us today to participate. So I'm very happy that like he invited us. So I am Tilaka, I am working with Nissan for the past 10 years. So I'm from Ooty. My native is Ooty in Tamil Nadu. So me and my family are settled here in Chennai. So I'm very happy to be part, like definitely I'm going to get enrolled in this club because I have that ambition to, because like I'm always a reserved person by nature. So I wanted to improve myself. I have to develop my confidence level. So I would like to thank Mr. Raghu to give me this platform.
How did you heard about Toastmasters before? Did you hear anything before other than me or?
So women in Nissan, we were participating in a forum, the women's forum. So there we heard about Toastmasters. So they were talking about these clubs which are available in Chennai. So they were asking all the women employees to get enrolled themselves who have their confidence level, who are not confident about themselves or to improve their communication skills. So immediately, like, we thought of enrolling all women in Nissan. We thought of enrolling in one of the clubs. But later on, all this COVID issues came up. So thankfully, now we came to know that Mr. Raghu is part of this club. So through him, we thought of enrolling. So he asked us to participate in this session so that, like, we will have an understanding what it's all about.
Great. Thank you so much, Tilaka, for that great introduction. To steer the whole meeting for today, we have a very committed and cool Toastmaster whom I have had a chance to work with in various contest share timing. Always helpful, and at any point of time, you can talk to him and you get the help and the response back. It's none other than Toastmaster Saravanan. Let's all put your hands together and welcome him as the Toastmaster of the day for today. Over to you, Toastmaster.
Thank you, Toastmaster Raghu. A couple of weeks back, during one of the online classes, my daughter attended an exam, online examination. She came back and told, "Dad, I have got 9 out of 10 marks." As a typical dad, I asked, "What happened to that one question?" She told, "If I have the power to go back in time and change that wrong answer, I would have got 10 out of 10. That rekindled my brain to see if there is any possibility, to go back in time and change something that has happened in the past. At that time, I read the clock that went backwards. It is not an anti-clock, but my own clock. It won't go backwards, it goes forward only. But there was a story in 18th century, that is in 1881, by one, it's a short story that went like this. Two boys went to their aunt's house and there was an antique clock in the 16th century that was found in the 15th century. And when turned backwards, it always reversed the flow of time. So those two boys went to the 16th century war, Anglo-Spanish war, that is called a Spanish Siege of Lisbon. So that the story went like that. And if you have now, I open a question to you. I ask a question to you. If you get that antique clock, what would you do? Just one or two people, please tell. It's not a TV topic. Unmute your mic and have it say. Okay, don't want to go, right? Okay, that's fine. So for me, it would be like going to the 18th century. So if you see, I got it from my daughter. You can see all the forts, okay? I'm not sure whether you can see or not, but this is the list of forts that you can see in India. I'm always fascinated by the fort. So I wanted to go to the 18th century to a fort called the Amber Fort in Rajasthan. You can see another fort called the Jaigarh Fort in Rajasthan. These forts are located very close to each other, but there is a tunnel between this Amber Fort and Jaigarh Fort. It was built in the 18th century, but I came to know that there are a lot of treasures that are inside that tunnel as such. So I would go to that 18th century to see how they have built that tunnel and what is the treasure. Maybe I can get that treasure also. So that is something like, I mean, I wanted to do. The next thing I would do is, I would go to 18th century in Golconda to see how that Golconda was transferred from India to British assets, because British taken that Golconda Kohinoor diamond and taken to British. So I wanted to go to 18th century to take that diamond back to India itself. So these are the things I wanted to do from myself. Toastmaster meeting, like in time, we have three different sections. Like in time, we have hours, minutes. Likewise, in Toastmasters meeting also, we have three different sections. One is the prepared speech section, where the Toastmasters will prepare something and then come and speak for 5 to 7 minutes or 12 to 14 minutes, depending on their project duration. The next one is the table topics, where the members as well as guests can talk extempore about any topic. The final segment is evaluation, where we can find out how well the entire meeting went ahead and then how we can improve as such. So what I would do is, I would like to introduce a person who would be the general evaluator for the entire meeting, and he would be explaining his function as such. For that, I would like to call upon Toastmaster Tyagarajan. He is somebody who is fondly called as Shakespeare of Toastmasters. He was baptized as a Toastmaster in 1974 in Royapeta YMCA Toastmasters Club. He is not only a seasoned speaker, but he also has a regular columnist in leading dailies, including Hindu, Deccan Herald, In Express, Statesman, and Tribune. So he has written more than 250 write-ups in those as a journalist. Please put your hands to welcome Toastmaster Tyagarajan, who would be explaining his entire function. Toastmaster Tyagarajan, welcome.
Yes. Okay. Yes. Salutations to all of you. This is Toastmaster Tyagarajan addressing you. Yes. It is a great privilege for me to do the role of general evaluator today. Yes, kind words have been said, for which I am very much grateful to Toastmaster Saravana. Evaluation, no speaker can afford to ignore it. He can ignore it at his own peril. Yes. Evaluation is results in productive and positive motivation. Evaluation improves the speech craft of a speaker. Still, evaluation, how will you describe it? It is like a golden ladder for a speaker. Fans evaluation, he will be in a losing end. He can't progress definitely. Even in our day-to-day life, we involve ourselves in our activities in the process of evaluation. First, I tell you that if you go to your doctor, I tell you. Yes, and you will present your complaint. Sir, doctor, yes, yesterday onwards, there is giddiness. Yes, so, and I am also a sense of nauseation. The doctor will not immediately declare you as a patient. He will ask you, he will inquire your age. Then he may read your BP. And he will also inquire you that whether you are a diabetic or not. Oh, how will you call this process? Evaluation. Is it not? Doctor evaluates your health and then she declares his diagnosis. And then she prescribes the medicine. Same is the case with every activity. Suppose if you propose someone to marry, a girl has been is in the point of being betrothed to you, naturally you will make an evaluation. What is her qualification? Very natural. And where does she study? Yes. What are her hobbies? Will she be a suitable match for me? Almost there will be a mental mutiny in you for and against. And that is nothing but evaluation. So, in this crucial process, today, I will be assisted by what you call a tag player. Yes. So, let me move step by step. Let me invite the accountant, Toastmaster Amita. Toastmaster Amita is doing a psychology in MOP Vaishnava College, a prestigious institution in the city. Now, I invite her, Amita, to come forward and give a brief description of your role. Please do come.
Yes, thank you, General Evaluator. So, hello everyone. I am here to introduce my role as the accountant for today. So, my role as accountant is to listen to the verbal distractions such as you know, so, and other filler words. I will also keep track of long pauses and repetitions. I will give a detailed report when called upon by the General Evaluator by the end of the meeting. Over to you, sir.
Next, I may have to call upon Toastmaster Mohana Sundaram. Yes, Mohana Sundaram is a software professional, and by profession, he is an engineer, qualified engineer, whose alma mater is Ranipet Engineering College. Yes. Now, he'll be doing the role of timer today. No, Toastmaster Mohan, will you please give a brief description of your role?
Thank you, General Evaluator. Thank you, General Evaluator, for a warm welcome. Fellow Toastmasters and our respected GTMs and welcome guests, good afternoon. As a timer, I will time the table topic, speakers, formal speeches, and evaluations. I will also alert each speaker at the time they have left using a green, yellow, and red cards, which denotes the specific time they have. For the table topic, speakers should limit their remarks to no more than 2 minutes. At 1 minute, I will raise the green card. At 1:30, I will raise a yellow card. At 2 minutes, I will raise a red card. Those giving the speeches should limit the remark to the specific times. For the prepared speeches, it should be 5 to 7 minutes. At 5 minutes, I will raise a green card. At 6 minutes, I will raise a yellow card. At 7 minutes, I will raise a red card. For the evaluations, it should be 2 to 3 minutes. At 2 minutes, I will raise a green card. At 2:30, I will raise a yellow card. At 3 minutes, I will raise a red card. Thank you, General Evaluator. Over to General Evaluator.
Now, okay. Thank you very much, Mr. Mohana Sundara. Yeah. Now, let me move on to the next role player, Gramaria, perhaps the watchdog of this meeting. Yes, it is played by none other than an outstanding Toastmaster, Mr. Jagannathan. Yes, someone said music is the nearest way to the greatest pleasure. Yes, yes. And he is a firm believer in it. I see eye to eye with him on that. Music is the nearest way to the greatest pleasure. So Jagannathan, yes, he enjoys music. He can play music and we have the pleasure of listening to this music in the milestone meeting. He's thrilled and excited. And he can also play violin for information, I understand. Now, you, as a breadwinner, he is a software professional, I believe, and he studied in Meenakshi Sundararajan Engineering College. Now, Mr. Jagannathan, yes, I should, it will be a great privilege to look at your face because I didn't see the face of Vanita or any other except Mohan Sundaram. Yes, Mr. Jagannathan, yes. Yes, please give a brief description of your role.
Thank you, G. The role today that I play is that of a grammarian. Responsibility is to take note of good usages of English and not so appropriate usages of English and report it to the general evaluator at the end of the meeting. I also have the responsibility to introduce the word of the day. So I've introduced that in the chat window. The word of the day is benign. It's an adjective. I've also given the pronunciation of it. Yeah. The meaning is being gentle and kind, not harmful or severe. So there are two ways you can also, we might have heard people saying benign cancer, malignant cancer. We can also use this for person, people as well. So in that case, synonyms are tender, benevolent, mild. Antonyms, you can use harsh, rough, and malignant. Malignant comes in terms of tumor, cancer. And so the usage also I have given. So just for the benefit, I'll read the usages as well. The side effects of the vaccine are benign. The ruler was benign to the minorities in the state. A benign tumor will not cause you any fatal harm. I will also make note of how many people are using the word of the day. So I will produce my report to the general evaluator at the end of the meeting. Over to the general evaluator.
Look, let me all pray that all the Toastmasters should have a benign attitude. No one should have a malign attitude. I pray. Okay. Now, let me revert to TMOs.
Thank you, Toastmasters Thyagarajan. Now we come to the first phase of this meeting, that is the prepared speeches phase. In the prepared speeches, there are three speakers going to entertain us. They will take a central theme to inform or inspire or persuade the audience. So they will take the project based on their project objective. Listeners, audience, guests, Toastmasters, role players, everybody listen to the project. Note down how they introduce, how the body of the speech is, what are the positive areas, what are the improvement areas, and then compare notes with the evaluator at the end of the session. So that will keep you in good stead to improve your listening skills. Now coming to the first speaker. The first speaker would be Toastmaster TTM Thomas Abraham. Before reading out his project, may I call upon the evaluator, Toastmaster Renu Narayan, to read out his project objective.
Very good evening to all Toastmasters and guests. Today, my target speaker is DTM Thomas Abraham, and the purpose of this project is for the member to practice the skills needed to address audience challenges when he is giving a speech outside Toastmasters Club. Timer, please note, the timing is 12 to 15 minutes. Over to you, TM Modi. All the best to DTM Thomas Abraham.
Thank you, Toastmaster Renu Narayan. To introduce DTM Thomas Abraham, I would say he is a Meglian since January 2015. He had won a division finalist for 4 times in 3 genres. He is a 4-dimensional communicator. He combines writing, speaking, photography, as well as design skills, which is very much evident in his project, as well as how he communicates and how he represents in our Toastmasters meeting. If I have to use one acronym for him, it would be CEO, that is charming, energetic, organized. On the theme, when I asked him if he has the power to go back in time, what he would love to do, he told he would love to be in the Garden of Eden, living happily thereafter, avoiding the dangerous apple and avoiding the mistake, learning from history. Very poetic. I bring you DTM Thomas Abraham for his first for his project. It is in presentation mastery level 4, project 1, dealing with the difficult audience. DTM Thomas Abraham, over to you.
So you're on mute.
Thank you very much for such a wonderful introduction, TMOD of the day. Please allow me to upfront one norm for this session, which is let's be democratic in the disruption, which is part of the speech that I'm going to have. Let's be socialistic in distributing that time for disruption. Good afternoon, TMOD, dear Toastmasters, and welcome guests. Meetings can be graded based on the degree of liberty the audience is allowed to take. At one extreme are company AGMs, where the professional AGM speakers go on and on and on like mangled spaghetti, clearly showing untreated sadistic sickness. And very few chairmen confront and control this motor mouths. Similar can be housing societies, social clubs, but I hope Toastmasters is not included there. The other extreme, you have classrooms, some ceremonial and some religious meetings where audience has ears and eyes, but no mouths, zip up. In between lie office meetings. In such meetings, among the participants, we get to see three distinct types. First, the bloated ego. The bloated ego believes that he is God's greatest gift to the organization. He will go on and on and on to show off his superior knowledge and at times his ignorance. So full of himself, normally he is a poor listener. He is, or at least acts as if, unaware of the purpose of meetings, which is typically to maximize participation, for idea generation, and to finalize an action plan. Typically, he could be the senior VP who lost out in the CEO race. He has an axe to grind. He wants to show the CEO in bad light. So what does the CEO do? First, let me tell you what the CEO should not do. The CEO who conducts the meeting should not make it a duel. Don't reduce yourself to the level of the grouch and make it a fight between equals. Keep your distance, keep your height. Second, the leader should make sure that the conflict doesn't spiral out of control. In other words, the leader shouldn't lose his cool. Rule number one. So what can a leader do? He must understand that the agenda behind the move has to be noticed. The hidden meaning behind words have to be deciphered, and he has to deal with it. The argument was only a symptom. Deal with the underlying issues. The ripple is perhaps seeking attention. Remember, a rebel has the incentive of some applause. Two ways we can tackle this. If I'm confident, I must ask the rest of the team, hey, what do you think about this, what Mr. Kamath is saying? If they support it, if they find it sensible, then they will say it doesn't make much sense. Their support for me will mute the rebel. That settles the immediate problem. But if I'm not sure where the correctness of the issue is, I should ask the rebel, hey, how differently will you do it, Mr. Kamath? So Mr. Kamath explains. Then you turn to the team and ask, What do you think? And if the team agrees with Kamath, wonderful. That means there is some sense in it. So you accept it. I accept it. I was expecting some human interruptions. May I continue? Or does anyone have a question?
I'm sorry. Go ahead, sir.
No problem, because it's today, disruption is part of the menu. It's part of the course. So I thought, please go ahead. If you want to have a question for me, I will stop.
No question. I just got a call. Please go ahead.
Okay, fine. So, like I said, I turned to the team, and the team seems there's some sense in it. I say, hey, good idea, Mr. Kamath. So what happens? I'll be seen as a very open-minded person, and I can win over, and most probably the steam and the bile will go out of Mr. Kamath. Unless there is some underlying pathology. That has to be dealt with separately. Then you have the gripe. The gripe are some people without any agenda, but genetically they are disruptive. Like the hyperactive kiddos. They are genetically disruptive, argumentative, and worse still, negative. If the gripe hops too much of the common time, you must say that. Call him out. You must say that. And ask, in brief, what exactly is his objection. Ask him to be specific than just say, oh, things are not doing well, or we do it differently. Ask him, tell me, Mr. Kamath, how differently will you do it? Once he commits to a definitiveness, then it's easy. You discuss it on merit. You ask the team what you feel with, do a vote, and then go on with your task. The third, there are some people who are bold enough and original enough to think differently, think beyond conventional wisdom. People who are critical in a non-negative way. It is not destructive, it is constructive, but different. And why not? The world is made up of different people. So are solutions, possible solutions. They are great value to the organizations because they would perhaps tell us today what our competition would like us to overlook. They are the contrarians. Every gram worth their weight. Now, brainstorming, by the very word, creates positive conflicts and some heat at an intellectual level. But then it's up to the leader to make sure that this heat doesn't percolate down to the emotional level. Keep the person and the idea separate. Then you can be objective. And in group dynamics, objectivity is the only way out. Then the best outcome is in prospect. Now, for some reason, if the conflict turns adversarial, apply zero tolerance to personal attacks. The idea separate, the person separate. And don't allow it to occur at all. Nip it in the bud. Let the group then judge alternative views with the litmus test of common objectives, common good, common sense. So that is the common point, common denominator on which we can judge things. Good leaders encourage all participants to speak up. Get all the alternatives on the table. Get the best solution out of it. A good leader doesn't let anyone dominate, including himself. Show that intellectual equality by pre-setting the ground rules, which applies to everybody. I once met a youngster in a night train who had joined the Satish Dhawan Space Center in Sriharikota. I was surprised to hear that those engineers worked 11, 12 hours in that public sector undertaking happily. I asked him why. He told me that equal weightage for voices is a speciality there, irrespective of seniority. After all, the rocket obeys scientific facts, not the opinion of the boss, isn't it? So there, they have complete scientific outlook and objectivity. Now, as a leader, it's our responsibility to make sure that two or three people don't kill the momentum of the speech, the meeting, or douse the energy and demotivate people. Isolate the malady. Call people out of this smoke screen of vagueness. Force them into definite statements. Then apply the logic of common logic and common sense. Use humor if you have. I have a dearth of that. Be patient.
Thomas, sir, but the you've been talking about leaders and things like that, right? But if you look into the current young leaders thing, which often comes in, you always look into this micromanagement point of view, right? And then it becomes a nuisance. So that's something which, I don't know, how do you address that kind of thing?
Good point. Those who are result-oriented, some of them tend to do this. If they, when they are not assured, they tend to do this. As habit, some people do it. But Toastmaster Raghu, I agree with you. We can have a debate on that. But here, I was only discussing how to manage a meeting. We were discussing three types of disruptions, three types of mines, you know, landmines that a leader has to negotiate when taking on a meeting. Now, that is, be that as it may, micromanagement, like I said, it's a function. You have a leader, you have a performing team, you have a task, you have a deadline. In the middle of this, the style of leadership evolves. Also, the background of the leader. Far too many factors for me to give you a linear answer. But yes, I agree with you. Again, I'm unable to give an absolute answer because what level are we looking at? Are we looking at the labor level? Are we looking at the intellectual level? So I will be very happy to have a debate, maybe a discussion. Maybe we will have a question and answer session on this. Did I satisfy you anywhere, Toastmaster Raghu?
Yes,
Toastmaster. No, I'm willing to supplement because I was asked to expect very many interruptions, but you've been such a nice audience, not allowing me to learn how to tackle disruptions. So I'm willing to take more disruptions.
Sir, this is Narasimhan here, if I may. I have a question to ask. Sure. Sir, you're talking about these three stereotypes, right, which you typically come across in any of the meetings. But by bucketing people or by going with preconceived notion that you will come across, say, these three sets of people as a CEO, as a leader, don't you think you're actually prejudiced? You're getting into the meeting, being judgmental about coming across these three types of people. And as a CEO, I believe that your duty is to answer all sorts of questions and clear the doubts of the people. So don't you think by dividing people or by going with this preconceived notion that you will come across these three types of people, you're actually not, say, playing the role of CEO appropriately?
I agree. It's a little like this. We say if you have a running nose, this may be the problem. If you have loose motion, this may be the problem. These preconceived notions are our way of getting out of trouble. We could be wrong, just like we judge people based on certain behavioral signals. I agree with you. Here, what are we doing? We are not creating confrontation. We are avoiding confrontation. If you notice, in all the three cases, the end result is positive because, like I said, this is a landmine. But remember, I am the leader. So I have the responsibility to reach the entire wagon, beyond getting disrupted this way. So therefore, objective being my responsibility, I would not disrupt it. Even if I have a preconceived notion, I'm not applying it. I'm asking my group to judge. It is a warning I'm taking so that I can duck if a bullet comes. I agree with you otherwise. Yes, there is an element of judgment in all our behavior, starting with the smallest child. I agree. It's a defense mechanism, it's a safety mechanism. Yeah, we got to be conscious of that and don't be prejudicial. I think that's a great lesson you are telling me out of this. I'm with you 100% on that. So, you're right. Did I answer your question somewhat?
Yes, sir, definitely.
Thank you. So, to complete what I wanted to say at the end, isolate the malady. Call people out of the small screen of vagueness. Bring everybody, all opinions on a firm ground. Then we can be objective and judge. Thank you all for being such a wonderful audience. If you have the time for any questions without the timer disqualifying me, I'm open. Thank you very much. Thank you.
Thank you, DTM Thomas Abraham. Keep the person and the idea separate. If I have to use a rhetoric device, whimsical words of wisdom from the wizard. Thank you for that wonderful grace. We move on to the next speaker. That is, this person is a lovely person. For this person, like the evaluator would be Toastmaster Surya. Toastmaster Surya, can you please provide the project objectives for lovely Orient, the magic carpet of e-commerce?
Yeah, thank you, sir. Lovely Orient, good afternoon, fellow Toastmasters and guests. Lovely Orient is delivering her project in dynamic leadership level one, last project, which is research and presenting, where our project objective says that the speaker, the member, should learn and review basic research methodologies and present a well-organized and well-researched speech on any topic. So by this speech, Lovely Alien will be completing her level one in her pathway dynamic leadership. Over to you. All the best, Lovely Alien.
Thank you, Toastmaster Surya. To introduce the speaker, Lovely Alien, she's currently pursuing her master's in economics at Madras School of Economics. She's a cheerful person who looks for positivity in each and every aspect of life. She's a foodie and an epitome of sarcasm at times. On the theme, when I asked her if she has the power to go back in time, she mentioned she would go back to the year 2018, where she had a lot of new experiences and learning that year. Toastmaster Lovely Orient, project speaker to the magic carpet of e-commerce, Lovely Orient. Over to you.
Hello, sir. Is the screen visible? Or like PPT is visible? Yeah. Okay. So, how many of you prefer or used to prefer online shopping over offline shopping, like before this COVID era? So many of us prefer online shopping over this traditional shopping method. Now we do prefer, but India is gradually becoming the largest educated people in the world over the internet because of easily accessible mobile phones and cheap internet services like than before. So e-commerce has made life easier for all of us. Like many of us order from food to clothes, medicines, all everything online. So good evening, fellow Toastmaster, dear guests. A very good evening to one and all. So I have lived in different cities for studies. So all thanks to e-commerce for its easier access and faster delivery services of every product in a hostel. So I order most of my products online only, be it clothes, foods, and medicines, fruits, milk, to name some of my favorites are Dunzo for milk, Amazon, Myntra, and of course, Swiggy and Zomato for late night food cravings in hostel. So also the expansion and reach of e-commerce has increased significantly over this past 2-3 years in small cities and towns, and in fact in villages also. So there are many advantages of e-commerce. So the most significant one site is we all know that it is accessible and convenient to purchase 24/7. And there are also many options and range available. Like we can buy it like according to our budget and interest. So, and also the global presence has made it like we can purchase the product from anywhere and it get delivered to the to our home. So, and so we can compare the prices of different premium brands with the product we are purchasing and we can compare accordingly. That we can't do. We have to invest a lot of time when we purchase, when we do traditional shopping with comparing and going in different outlets of every brand. And it is of course time saving to purchase online things. Like it's the best advantage of e-commerce. We can also review the products before purchasing by seeing the positive and negative reviews, and we can get to know the pros and cons of the product before purchasing the product. Also, sometimes the product is of different quality that we see online. So some e-commerce websites offer return facility, and if the product is not of good quality, if there is any damages. So we have seen that there are so many advantages of e-commerce, but there are some limitations also attached to it. If we compare it to traditional shopping experiences, which are we are unable to examine the products physically. Like if I buy a clothes or a top, I won't get to know that physical what the cloth is made up of. Like it shows what is, but we can't get the physical touch of the product, like how it looks, like how it is actually looking, and like it's because of the different variations in image and all. So also the most importantly, security is the most concerned things when we do online shopping. So we should always see the site security certificate before doing any online transactions on e-commerce sites. Also, there are so many products which we need immediately. E-commerce won't help in that. Like in majorly in metropolitan cities, it can deliver. It has faster delivery services. But when it comes to small town and cities, there is always a delay in delivering products. So it is the major limitation that we can't order perishable products and all to every place. Also, there is the inability to identify the fraud. Like in traditional shopping experience, it's easier to do all that. Like in some websites like Myntra, there is also hidden cost available, like attached to the product. Like when we see the product, the price is different, and when we during the checkout and payment, it adds additional taxes and all convenience fee, which is hidden cost, which we don't have in normal traditional experiences. So the next question is this e-commerce is a problem for in this COVID-19 era? So many of us are experiencing this quarantine and elevating to get we are getting to the time for our loved ones and family and friends. So many of us are reluctant to go outside because of fear of getting sick. So a recent morning consult study have given us their research that 24% of people don't want to go for mall shopping even after 6 months after coming the vaccine also. And around 16% of the people don't want to will go within the next 3 months. So we are enforcing the consumers are changing the online pattern and behavior in on the online buying habits. Like many families are purchasing everything online, fruits, everything, and this it will replace the retail shopping, and it will replace mall and the general store if the situation prevails. And also many people don't want to get out of their homes even after vaccine is available. They will see the results, how it comes, and they will change their behavior accordingly. So this traditional shopping experience and this online shopping experience have a gap in according to them, in limitation and advantages. So at last, I would like to end it with a quote that at present, instead of buying bananas in a grocery store, you could go pick them off a tree in a virtual jungle. So thank you. Over to you, Timur.
Thank you, Toastmaster Lovely Arun. During this hour of pandemic, there are two things that are needed. One is e-commerce or online shopping. The next one is a magic carpet to move around the places without any disturbance. Thanks for talking about that topic. The next speaker, speaker number three, Toastmaster Rangarajan, would speak gently. So for speaking about his project objectivity, I would like to call upon his evaluator, DTM Sampath Sauvidarjan. DTM Sampath Sauvidarjan.
Good evening. Good evening. Toastmaster of the day, fellow Toastmasters, am I audible? Okay. I got a slight problem in my PC, but I am also on my mobile in the name of Silva, so don't worry about that. Toastmaster Ranga is doing level 2 project 2, understanding the communication style. Our TMOD will be happy because this is sort of putting the clock back, backward working clock, because we have already developed the communication style in the past. Now we are trying to analyze it. The speech part of the project will be presented by Toastmaster Ranga, and I will read the objectives now. The purpose of this project is for the member to learn about different communication styles and identify his or her primary style. The purpose of this speech is for the member to share the impact of his or her style on others. Good luck to the speaker and nice hearing for all of us. Back to the Toastmaster of the day.
Thank you, DTM Sampath Sauvidarjan. To introduce the speaker, Ranga, he likes optimism and believes that everything happens for a reason. On the theme of the day, if he is given the power to turn the clock backwards, he would like to go back to his college days. Two things happened during his college days. Great friends and great music of Ilayaraja. Fantastic thanks listening to Ilayaraja's music. Over to Toastmaster Ranga for speaking gently. Speaking gently to Toastmaster Ranga.
Good afternoon. Am I audible? Hello?
Yes, Ranga.
Okay.
Yes, you are audible.
Thank you. The shortest literary correspondence on the
floor. Who is the evaluator? See, there have been some changes, it seems. Is it? Who is the evaluator? And what about that the very first speaker, Kalyan? Oh, it has been replaced. I don't mind, but I want to know. First speaker did not appear, Kalyan. Sir. So instead, Thomas Abraham spoke. And then Sampath Sauvidarjan, he has been posted as evaluator. I thought there will be some animation in his lips, but he has been keeping quiet. And then, no, I don't want to know the changes.
I'm not going to recent time
I
for
commit any guffey. Hmm? What are the changes?
Yeah, we'll come
what
back. Sir, the speaker has started already. Kindly allow the third speaker to complete. Thank you.
We'll call you and let you know, Tegrat.
Third speaker, who is the evaluator? Evaluator.
So there has been a change in the speech order and saying speech speaker. So DTM, Thomas Abraham took the first speech. Kalyan was not on joining today.
Okay, let me try this again. The shortest literary correspondence on record was between Victor Hugo and his publisher, Hearst and Blackett, in the year 1862. The author was on a holiday and was anxious to know about this new novel, Les Miserables, was selling. He wrote a question mark and sent it to his publisher. And the response he got back from his publisher was an exclamation mark. Everything was going good. Good afternoon, Toastmasters of the day, fellow Toastmasters, and soon to be Toastmasters. I must thank my mentor, DTM Thomas Abraham, for his patience and his graciousness. There are four distinctive styles of communication: supportive, initiating, analytical, and direct. Supportive style is calm, steady, approachable, sincere, and gentle. This style has always worked best for me. Through my IT career, I was in quality assurance. Very early into the job, I realized that the best way to assure product reliability was to have friendly relations with the development team, both software and hardware. Nobody likes to hear that their code is error-filled or the firmware is faulty. To circumvent this, what I did was, because I worked in a flat hierarchy, I was able to go and speak to the developers and point out the differences between my results and the design and requirement document. This helped me a lot in building a rapport with the development team. They did not view me as an enemy, but rather as a friend who could work collaboratively with them. After all, we were on two ends of the same spectrum. We wanted to give a good product, to dispatch a good product with very few defects. Initiating style of communication is all about life, being gregarious, enthusiastic, spontaneous, and fun-loving. I joined the bank immediately after my graduation. Work environment was extremely friendly. By the time I had reached my mid-20s, I felt that I needed to give back something to the society. I joined a few friends who were like-minded, and our thought was to go to some remote village or a hamlet to teach the underprivileged children basic math, spoken English, and also to teach their parents the art of signing their names and to do away with the thumb impressions. So on searching a lot of places, we felt that we didn't want to do it in the city. We moved a little bit away to a place called Uttandi, which is halfway to Mahabalipuram. This hamlet had about 30 huts and a few children. So we used to go there every alternate Saturday and be with the children. Of course, not all the children joined. Some of them were very timid. So how do we overcome this? So I thought of a couple of ways. One was to take some toffees with me. So on seeing them, I would immediately offer a toffee with them and try to make them feel comfortable. The other one was to ask their parents to come and sit down next to them to take away their shyness. And of course, the third one was quite innovative. What I did was, I used to call them, address them by a wrong name or deliberately mispronounce their name. So immediately they will look startled and they will say, no, that's not my name. My name is this. So we were able to gently bring them into the fold, and we did it for a few years. Those days are still fresh in my memory. The next style of communication is analytical. Here, everything is bound by a logic, precision, and you want to be organized. So when I think about it, every place I have worked, I had to do all these things. And how do I communicate this? Well, a recent example stands up. My laptop, the hinges on my laptop suddenly broke loose and my screen was dangling from the keyboard. I definitely needed a laptop. I couldn't be without one. So, but fortunately, I had taken an extended warranty. And I thought this hardware defect would be covered in that. When I spoke to the manufacturer, they came back and said that, hey, this sort of hardware issue is not covered in your warranty. I had no other choice. And over and above that, they had sent me an invoice to get this repaired. So I was caught in two minds, but I definitely need, since I needed the laptop, I paid for it. A couple of days later, I got an authorization form in my email, which said that you have to sign this and send it back for us to order for replacement. As I was going through the list of items, I found that there was one particular line which said the hardware warranty for any item purchase, the hardware warranty for any new laptop will be valid for 4 years. I was well within that limit. Armed with this new fact, I called him up again and we had a back and forth. We went for a few hours talking about this, and the beauty of it was I had to explain to them about their own rules and regulations. Finally, the manufacturer admitted that there was a problem from their side and it would be addressed as early as possible. So they have refunded the money now and I'm waiting for the spare part. So these three styles, in my view, these three styles are the ones which are suited to me best. The supportive style, where being reliant without passing too much of a rupture help me go through different jobs, as well as initiating and analyzing. Back to the Toastmasters.
Thank you, Toastmasters Rangarajan, for sharing your benign experiences. With this, we have come to the end of the preferred speech session. Now we will go to the next session, that is the table topic session. The table topics is a very impromptu session where you have to talk extemporaneously and you have to speak few words. Somebody is having their microphone open. Can you please mute yourself if you are not speaking? Thank you. We are going to the next session, that is the table topic session. And this is a very keen session, which is keenly noted by all the guests as well as members as well, in which you have to speak few words about impromptu speaking for a minute to 2 minutes. Mark Twain once mentioned, it usually takes 3 weeks to prepare a good impromptu speech, but you will not have that kind of time. So you have to talk on your feet within that 1 to 2 minutes. So for introducing the table topic master, I would like to introduce you to Pavitra Sridhar. She's a quick learner, sport lover, and a HR by profession. On the theme, when I asked if she had the power to go back in time, she mentioned she would like to go back to a school day, relive childhood watching Popeye, Tom and Jerry, and playing with friends and living a carefree life. Presenting to you, Toastmaster Pavitra Sridhar. Pavitra Sridhar, over to you.
Thank you for that introduction, Saravanan. Can you all hear me? Can I have a thumbs up? Perfect. All right. Good afternoon, Toastmasters and guests. Welcome to one of the most interesting parts of Toastmasters meeting, which is the table topic session. I will be the table topic master for today. We will have slightly an added bonus in the session today where we'll have some brand slogans that are presented and the audience can guess which brand it is. So once we have a tagline and a brand guessed, I will present a topic and I will call out a speaker. Each speaker will have about 2 minutes to speak on the topic. I would request you all to kindly pin the timer before you start speaking. I will just start sharing my screen. Just give me a thumbs up when you can see my screen. Okay. So just starting off, the first brand tagline is "Just Do It." Anyone can unmute and answer. Which brand this tagline belongs to?
Nike.
Great. That was the right answer. Nike was the right answer. The first topic would be actions speak louder than words. Can I have Narsimhan to take the first topic? The one who guessed the answer first as well.
Thank you. And I was hoping for a much benign topic to talk about. First of all, good afternoon, fellow Toastmasters and guests. Actions speak louder than words. Yes, people usually say that the hands which help are a lot better than the lips that pray. So if in case if you want to help someone instead of praying, just ensure that whatever help that you can do to that person in terms of action, be it in terms of say helping them out of the situation, whatever possible, if you're able to do that actionably, that'll do the person a world of good rather than just speaking. And even say in Toastmasters, or probably say even in our workplace, we are known more by the actions that we do rather than the words that we speak. So definitely actions speak louder than words. And probably that's what I can think of. Over to you, Table Topics Master.
Thanks, Narasimhan, for that benign speech. Next up, the next brand slogan is Born Tough. Any guesses on which brand slogan this is?
See it.
That's right. Great, Narasimhan. You seem to have a hang of most of the slogans here.
For you, Narasimhan.
Sorry, Jagan, I missed that.
No chocolates for you.
Thank you. Virtual.
Yeah. So the next topic is courage is knowing what not to fear. Can I have Atishai, the most new member of Medley? Atishai, are you here?
Yeah, yes.
Okay. Courage is knowing what not to fear. That's your topic, Atishai. Over to you.
All right. So when we think of someone as courageous, what is the first thing that comes to your mind? We remember warriors, we remember people who fought in wars, we remember generals, we remember people who martyred in battle. That is the typical image of courage that we have all grown up with. But when you actually think what courage is, it is not about not fearing anything. It is about knowing what not to fear, what not to be afraid of. This reminds me of a very good quote that I read. If you breathe oxygen, I do not fear you. If you breathe oxygen, I do not fear you. This is something that a courageous man would say. Because if any person, if you are the same as me, I have no reason to be afraid. Courage is not, every person has some fears. Every person has things that they are afraid of. It is essentially impossible to be completely free of fears. However, you can still be courageous by knowing that there are a few things that I will not be afraid of. There are a few challenges that I will take on. And I know that I will take on those challenges and I will conquer those challenges. Thank you.
That was indeed a courageous attempt, Atishai. Moving on to the next tagline, think different, I think pretty easy. Any guesses on which brand tagline this is? Anybody, any guesses?
Apple.
That's right. Who was that?
Zakir.
Great, Zakir. That's right. Apple is, think different is Apple's slogan, of course. The next topic is logic will get you from A to Z. Imagination will get you everywhere. Can we have Rohit? Is Rohit around? No. All right. Can we have Sundaresan attempting the topic? Mr. Sundaresan?
Yes, table topic, Master. Good afternoon, fellow Toastmasters. Certainly, logic will take us from all the 26 alphabets from A to Z. But imagination will take us everywhere in all the directions. One of the quote of Chanakya, I remember now with this is, the fragrance of flowers moves in the direction of the wind, but the knowledge of the person spreads in all direction. So if the imagination is there and it's blended with creativity, there lies the talent of that theme which that person likes to convey for the society. Logically, something will be right for one person, and the same logic may not work out same for the other person. So there is an element of risk and fear also in that one. But imagination with discussion and implementing proven law, imagination with creativity certainly will benefit the society and the individual and the nation also. Over to table topic.
That was a nice speech indeed, Sundaresan. Thank you. The next slogan is Open Happiness. Any guesses on which brand this is? It is a beverage, just to give you all a hint.
Coca-Cola?
That's right. Aishwarya, right?
Yeah, yeah.
Great, Aishwarya. That's correct. Coca-Cola, that's the brand tagline. Would you want to attempt the table topic as well? Aishwarya, the table topic is people are just as happy as they make up their minds to be. All right. Okay. Would someone else want to take an attempt? So
I can take Zakir here.
Great, Zakir. Go ahead. People are just as happy as they make up their minds to be.
Yeah. Thank you, Pavitra, for the topic. People are just happy as they make up their minds to be. Truly said. Mind is nothing but a bundle of feelings and emotions controlled together. So whenever we control our emotions, our feelings, we seem to be very happy. Same thing happens with hermits and the kids newly born. They have the happiness within them because their mind is not controlled. It is free flowing. The way we grow, we start growing, we start creating a lot of bundles within the minds and start controlling our feelings and emotions. We get into bind to that and we start losing our happiness. So happiness particularly leads to only the way you think about your life, and everything will pass on. That is the way of life. Nothing stays here forever. So that way, when you talk about the people are just happy because when they allow their minds to lead the what it is happening and let it go. And this kind of a happy mind will only make a person to live longer and live happier. And moreover, we can see the people who doesn't expect, doesn't prompt anything, doesn't think about any future are really happy. The people who are very constrained to a lot of things, like what the last topic was, even A to Z logics are there. People are really contained and they lose their happiness. So I really believe when the minds are free, you are always happy. Thank you.
Thank you for that speech, Zakir. Moving on to the next tagline, the taste of India.
Amul.
That's correct. Who was that?
Zakir.
Zakir, great. That was correct. This is the tagline of Amul. Can we have Mr. Shivakrishnan to take an attempt on the next topic? Shivakrishnan, are you there?
Yeah, Pavitra.
The topic is, it is health that is real wealth, not pieces of gold and silver. Go on.
Oh, thank you, Table Topics Master Father. Wonderful topic. So, good evening, fellow Toastmasters and guests. Mm-hmm. So, the most important aspect of any human being is his or her health, rather than the material possessions what she or he hold. Because at the end of the day, if you own millions but you are not able to eat anything or enjoy the real aspects of life, what is that life looks like? So it is quite important for every person to maintain a healthy, energetic life throughout their lifespan in this beautiful planet called Earth. So that's why I give very importance to setting up the day with a healthy habit on every day by starting with a workout of my choice. And sometimes I used to do yoga. So that's something that we need to cultivate as a part of our lifestyle to ensure that we live in our best ability so that we can give and share more to the fellow human beings. Thank you, Toastmaster. Over to you.
Great, Shivakrishnan. I think working out and keeping yourself fit is one of the best ways to start the day and healthy. Moving on to the next brand tagline, take care. It's a brand that involves cosmetics.
Garnier.
Perfect. That's right. Garnier is the brand. Next, can we have Venkateshan?
Yes.
Taking the next topic.
Yeah, no problem.
Topic is believe you can and you're halfway there.
Thank you, Pavitra. Nice topic. Believe you can and you are halfway there. I would like to take my Toastmaster experience, because I won for the past 3 months, 3 or 4 ribbons for table topics twice and grammarian one. My mind thinks always that instead of doing other projects, at least in the competition, in the contest, the upcoming contest, in table topic contest, I would like to get either the second place or the third place. That is my belief. I hope, I trust, I Benin definitely will get table topics contest this time, at least second place. This is my belief in Toastmasters. Thank you for the nice topic.
Thanks, Venkateshan, for that speech. Moving on to the next brand tagline, connecting people quite easily.
Yeah.
Nokia.
That's right. Great. So, can we have Sampath, the newest member? Sampath, is he here?
Hi. Yes, Pavitra. Yes,
great,
I'm here.
Sampath. I will just flash the next topic for you. So, if you want to live a happy life, tie it to a goal, not to people or things. Over to you, Sampath.
Thank you. Thank you, Toastmasters. Thank you for the opportunity. The topic is, if you want to live happy life, tied to a goal, not to people or things. Yes, of course, everybody wants to live happy life. Of course. So like to live happy life, we have to take it easy and healthy for all the situations. Whatever the circumstance, whatever the scenario comes, we'll have to take it as easy. So then only we can continue to live our happiest life. Like for everyone, they will get there will be ups and downs in all everybody's life. So but still, we have to go ahead and take it as a positive. Then it will be easy for us to live healthy, happy life. Happiness actually, people are always think once I succeeded in this life, once I have some bank balance or whatever it is, then I can be happy. Nothing like that. Actually, success is not the key to happiness. Happiness is the key to success. That's my quote I wanted to mention here. That's all about this topic. Thank you, Toastmaster. Over to you.
Great, Sampath. Thank you. That was a great attempt. Moving on to the next brand tagline, where leaders are made.
Toastmaster?
That's right. Yes, Narasimhan. Toastmasters, that's the tagline of Toastmasters, everybody. Can we have Dr. Alagappan? Dr. Alagappan to take the next topic. Are you there?
Yeah.
Great, Alagappan. I will just flash the next topic. A boss has the title, a leader has the people. That's your topic.
Okay.
Should I repeat?
Yeah.
The topic is a boss has the title, a leader has the people. That's your topic. Over to you, Alagappan.
So am I audible?
Yes.
Yeah, thank you. So, yeah. So this topic basically deals with the difference between a boss and a leader. Yeah. So I think a leadership is one thing. A person who is a leader has to have a vision and has to have people's faith, and not he has to be one among the people and not and should not force them or be a boss, act like a boss. While thinking about this topic, I remember an incident that Abdul Kalam was speaking about when he was working in a scientific research, like in a, sending a rocket. When the mission failed, his boss called and said that he will face the press, and he took the the mission didn't work. He took the blame, and when the next time the mission got succeed, he asked Abdul Kalam and said, "Go and now face the press," and he gave all the credit to the people who worked with him. So that is the quality of a leader, and he has got people along with him, and he never wanted the title. So that's an example of a leader, and that's what I wanted to say.
That was a great example, Dr. Alagappan. Good speech. Thank you. Moving on to the next tagline, the happiest place on earth. Any guesses which brand this could be?
Any clue?
This is something to do with kids.
Disneyland?
That's right. Who was that? I'm sorry, I can't.
Ramesh Rajendran.
Ramesh, perfect. That's Disneyland. That's the answer to that tagline. Next, can we have Lavanya Raghu, who is the latest new member, one of the new members, to take the topic? Lavanya, are you around?
Yeah, I'm there.
Great, Lavanya. Your topic is keep smiling, because life is a beautiful thing and there's so much to smile about. Over to you, Lavanya.
Yeah, so when you gave the topic, when you gave the tagline as the beautiful, the happiest place on earth, I just, the thing that came to my mind is is the home. So in home, be it our mom, our dad, our relatives, spouse, or kids, the smile is something that keeps us moving, being, you know, feeling motivated. It's a smile of the child when I just come to my home after a day's hard work, and when my husband comes back from home, is a smile of my daughter that gives us that boost, that gives us the stamina to, you know, speak to her, get the energy back. So what may come in your life, be it ups and downs, it's always the smile, it's always that positive energy that one should have, and should always see life more positive, because life is not definitely not bed of roses, and you have to keep smiling, because smile will help you to come out of the problem. Thank you so much.
Great. That was a great attempt, Lavanya. Thank you. Moving on to the next tagline. An idea can change your life.
Idea mobiles.
Right. That's correct, Narasimhan. I would like to have guest Madhumita. Are you around to take the next topic, Miss Madhumita? All right. Do we have guest Tilaga?
Yeah, Pavitra.
Great. I will just flash the topic. Great minds discuss ideas. Average minds discuss events. Small minds discuss people. That's your topic. Over to you, Tilaka.
Okay. Thank you, Ms. Pavitra. So like I could relate this to my own personal experience, you know, like previously when I first joined my company, I used to engage in gossiping, like, you know, like when we get together for a break time, I thought, okay, to discuss, to gossip about people, that would give me the pleasure. And later, when I gradually improving myself, when I was stepping into another role, then I came to know that gossiping, discussing about people, is a very, very bad habit. And then later on, we started discussing about the profile, the events, the current affairs, and then whomever who got into my circle, I would advise them that we would not be discussing about people, we would not be gossiping about any people in this group. And whenever we get together in a personal meeting or a group, we would discuss on great minds, we would discuss on great topics, the events, the current affairs. So I could relate this to my own experience. I've come out of it. I know, like, I'm gradually improving only because now, presently, I am concentrating on the events, not on the peoples. Thank you, Pavitra.
Great. That was a great personal story to share, Tilaka. Moving on to the next brand tagline. Very easy. I'm loving it.
McDonald's.
That's correct. That's right. For the next table topic, can I have Ramesh Rajendran attempting the topic? Are you there, yes. Ramesh?
Yeah, I'm online.
Great. If you judge people, you'll have no time to love them. That's your topic. Over to you, Ramesh Rajendran.
Good evening, Toastmasters, table topic selectors, and my dear guest. Today I am taking a topic on, if you judge people, you have no time to love them. In a real life scenario, we have came across many people, and since people are so different in their mind, in their way of thinking, in their way of approach of a particular situation, people tend to judge. For example, if a person is doing a particular approach, which is a conventional, and another person who takes a risk, so people would say like, okay, he's taking a risk. Why is he doing that? Take a safe route and, you know, proceed with it. Why is he doing this? But instead of judging people, you should see the good qualities in them. He's taking risk because it's a part of an experience which he's doing. He has done something in order to take an experience, and for that only he is taking risk. People should be more open-minded, and these times, people should come up with this open mind, so that people, instead of judging, they can find a good benign characteristics in each people and love them. Thank you. Back to Tosma, the table topic.
Great attempt, Ramesh Rajendran. It was really nice hearing you out on the topic. Moving on to the next tagline, the power of knowledge.
Is it Google?
Economic Times is the answer. Okay. That's the answer to the tagline, the power of knowledge. Can we have Abhinaya, the guest, to take up this topic? Are you there?
Yes, Pavitra.
Great. Your topic is, knowledge will give you power, but character will give you respect. That's your topic, Abhinaya. Over to you.
Yeah. Good evening to all. The topic is, knowledge will give you power, but character will give you respect. So I could remember one incident in my life that we have one of our team member who is very, very knowledgeable person. And it's very difficult to approach him. So for a new member in the team, so anybody doesn't like to talk to him or be very fearful or very scared to talk to him. But there is also another person who helps people out voluntarily. And that person, we used to contact them very often, and we used to have a very good friendship over him. So work-wise, we see that we are more involved when we work with a people who is very friendly in nature and who is helping others. Whereas even though the other person is knowledgeable, we were not able to approach him because of how he take up how he acquaintance with the other people. So this is a very learning for me, that knowledge will give you power, but character will give you respect. And we have a lot of respect towards the person who is showing helping hands to everyone. So thank you, Pavitra.
Thank you, Abhinaya. That was a good attempt as well. Moving on. No confusion, great combination.
Bingo.
Right, Narasimhan. That's correct. Bingo has that tagline called No Confusion, Great Combination. Can we have our member Dinesh attempting the next topic? Dinesh, are you there?
Yeah. Yes, Pavitra.
Great, Dinesh. Your topic is life is either a daring adventure or nothing at all.
Okay. Thank you, Madam Table Topic Master, for the topic. Good afternoon, Toastmasters and guests. Life is an adventure for everyone, but we don't experience it in the right manner. I read a quotation somewhere saying that what are the biggest regrets that people who die at the age of 90 or above, what do they regret most about? And most of them tend to say that the biggest life is that they haven't tried something in new business. They haven't tried to take any sort of risk or something like that. So perhaps it's the best to take the adventure and be more adventurous and try to do something which I haven't done in our daily life at all. Because otherwise it's just a genuine life. Work till 60 and then get retired and then the life goes on. It'll be like any other thing. We have to take an adventure. Even I have seen some people even in their 60s doing bungee jumping and all some really, really daring things. I don't know how, from where they can do. They have so much of courage they do. I have seen people, elderly people taking on the roller coasters and all. They can have so much of courage and they can do so much of things. And these are the memories that they will always want to take back with them. After all, it's a small mark that we can make in our life. And thank you, Madam Table Topic Master. Over to you.
Thank you so much, Dinesh. That was a great attempt as well. I really enjoyed hearing some personal examples, some quotations and all of that during the table topic session. Hope you all had some fun too. Thank you, and over to you, TMOD, Sarunan.
Thank you, Toastmaster Pavitra Sridhar. That was a very innovative session. I have heard terms like brand equity, brand personality, brand management, but we can add this also, I guess. Brand table topic. Thanks for having the topic associated with the brand. Well done. Now, with this, we have come to the end of the second session, the table topic session. Now, the third session is evaluation session. You know, feedback is the breakfast of champions. So, please put together your hands to welcome Toastmaster Tyagarajan for his evaluation session.
Tyagarajan. Oh, it was, I enjoyed very much. It is a kind of education for me, especially the TT session. Yes. Now, let me move to the evaluation session. The first evaluator is none other than the outstanding Toastmaster, Ms. Renu Narayana. Yes. Renu Narayana, I can tell you, she is a bibliophile. Yes. And she has a passion for gardening. Yes. And added to it, she's a lover of animals. Yes. She always keeps company with her pets. Now, yes, very exciting personality. Please, you can set the ball in motion by evaluating Toastmaster, I think Thomas Abraham's speech.
Very good evening to all Toastmasters and guests, and thank you, GE, for introducing me. Today, my target speaker was DTM Thomas Abraham,
And I must say that the challenge was to face a difficult audience, but I think your audience has been very benign today because there's hardly any interruptions. Now, what I would like to say is you excelled at confidence levels. You were very, very confident. And the only three interruptions were one was from Ramesh. I think he was meant to be the interrupter, and he did interrupt you, but you dealt with it very calmly. And he actually said that he doesn't have anything further to say. And then your second interrupter was, I think, the arguing type, which was Narasimhan. And you dealt with that also very well. And the third person was our Toastmaster, Raghunath. I think all the three interruptions were pretty much handled in a very calm manner by you. And then I would say that, this is as far as how you dealt with the audience very nicely. But I would suggest that at the very beginning, your project is supposed to ask you to make a few like this. You're early in the session, you're supposed to tell participants to note all their comments and questions, assure the audience will address these at the end of the session, and keep participants engaged by asking them to complete an interactive learning session. This did not happen. So I think there were a couple of interruptions, which is anyway going to happen even if you give these instructions. But I think this was part of your project, which you did not address. And also I felt that the two people who interrupted you, Narasimhan and Raghunath, I think you took it a little too far. You kept giving them a lot of explanation. You kept agreeing with them and you lost track of your own speech. I don't know whether you completed your speech. I think by the time was running out, I think you could have handled it in such a way that you could have completed your speech on time. And to summarize, I would say that you did display all the qualities of a leader right through. And what I would suggest for you to challenge yourself is perhaps to give the same speech again, so that you can deal with the more difficult audience, because I think these are challenges that we are definitely going to face outside of Toastmasters, and it's very, very important for us to understand how we should deal with frequent interruptions. Then, to summarize, I would say that you did a wonderful job as a speaker, in the sense that you remained calm right through, you did not lose angry, and like I said, if you can just perhaps not delay your speech by getting too much into the interruptions, I would say that it would have been a wonderful, better attempt by you. And to conclude, yes, I enjoyed your speech. I'm not supposed to focus on the content of the speech, so I would not comment on that, but I think you achieved your project, and thank you very much. Over to you, General Evaluator.
Now let's move on to the next evaluator, Toastmaster Surya. Yes. The face is the index of your mind. So, without taking any pinch of salt, I can vouch say that Mr. Surya is very much a committed Toastmaster. Yes. So, I invite him to do evaluation for Mr. Lovely Aryan's speech. Surya.
Thank you, Professor Kalaratham, for the introduction. Good evening, fellow Toastmasters and guests. So I would like to congratulate Lovely Aryan for completing her level one project successfully. The topic was about the magic that was making in everybody's life, which was the online shopping. Recent days, we would have definitely started using it very well every day in our life. So to speak about her, the positives of her speech, number one, I would say eye contact. She had a good eye contact throughout this. Throughout her speech, most of the time she was looking at the camera and she was speaking, so which was really nice. And second thing was the comfort level in terms of using the presentation, the PowerPoint presentation. So she was able to manage it well with any kind of hassle. When she was speaking, the content was again getting displayed in the PowerPoint presentation through her screen sharing. So that you have did it well. And third thing is that audience connect. Audience connect in terms of the information that you provided. Did it reach the audience? I felt I could able to get clearly understand whatever you spoke throughout from the beginning till the end I was there. This was clear and audible and understandable by the by myself. And the other area of focus that you were trying to compete was repetition, avoiding repetition. So I felt that you have well managed with avoiding usage of repetition very well. And then next, let's go with the recommendations. Recommendations, I believe vocal variety needs to be improved a little bit. I felt throughout the speech it was flat, your voice. So you lost usage of repetitions. You were using too many crutch words. So that I felt could be avoided. And third thing is that this speech requires to be researched well with a lot of information, like statistical information. Where if there were not much of a statistical data that you provided, since this, whatever the information that you gave was almost well known by the people who use it daily on a daily basis. So you could have included a lot of information such as how many users are there, how many people are getting benefited out of it, and which country is using the highest numbers like that. And the final recommendation was you could have well related with the current situation that has been happening. So these are all the recommendations that I have. All the best to your next speech. And by the way, I missed your 60 seconds, last 60 seconds of your speech. So I will go through the YouTube video and also be providing that other comments as well. Thank you.
Thank you, Surya.
Yeah. Next is a trailblazing Toastmaster. Yes. With an inimitable academic record. Yes. His alma mater is one of the premier institutions in India. Indian Institute of Technology, and he served overseas. And every medallion has to have to think of him. Why, you may ask? When Medley was in turbulent waters, yes, it was once. It was Toastmaster Sampath Rajan as Vice President of Education. He steered it safely to the shore. Yes, he saw to it that Medley went on smoothly.
Can we start? There is some audio problem.
Yes, sir. Please go ahead, Sandeep sir.
I am visible and audible.
Yes, you are.
No, how it repeat? No, there is a communication gap. No, what is it? Again, introduce Dr. Sampath Saurirajan, because I don't see any animation at all and don't hear anything.
No, sir, he's fine. Doctor is there. Doctor, please carry on. Doctor, please carry on. Thank you.
Doctor, you carry on. Yes.
Okay.
Thank you. Good afternoon, General Evaluator, fellow Toastmasters, and Toastmaster Ranga in particular. Today, Ranga did this project, Understanding Communication Style from Level 2. The message is how the speaker used different communication styles. That was the message that came out of that. And he indirectly showed that he has got a clear understanding of the communication styles as given in the project. It was a very good speech. Did you like it? Did you like it? Give him a big round of applause. Now, let me talk about the project. Because the purpose statement says about project as well as the speech, both should be addressed during the evaluation. This is my opinion. So the project is, in most cases in pathways, it has got an activity either of studying or doing or leading or something like this. Based on this and the experience and results, the speech is made. So the project itself, how we did it, I had an interaction with the speaker earlier today to know how he did it. I am glad to inform you that he has done an excellent job. He has taken the survey which showed that supportive and initiating are his main styles. These matched with his, the impression he carried about himself all along. As a result of study, he would like to include analytical style also in his toolbox for future. But he is not ready to include direct communication as it doesn't appeal to him. He had consulted his mentor though mainly for his script. So these are the project activities. I applaud him for that. Coming to the speech, easy handling of the practical examples, three of them from his life experience. Clearly, logically, he showed the three different styles, supportive style, initiating style, and analytical style. As for the, he excelled in the speaking skills also, clear diction, good language, good hand gestures, though not too much of vocal variation, but that is okay for this project. Structurally, it was a topical outline, but the opening and closing have been most striking. You should work on this aspect. Transitions were very clear. You should talk more on his study results directly. These are my recommendations and good luck to him in future. Back to the general evaluator.
Please. Okay.
Thank you very much, Dr. Sauri.
No, okay. Now, let me move to the what the tag role players have to say on this meeting. First, I invite Amita. I mean, her counter.
Yes, sir. Can you hear me?
Yes.
Her counter.
Yeah, I'll just share my screen. Hope you guys can see it. Coming to the tag report of the R counter. Starting with the essay, Saranya, she had zero repetitions, no pauses, one filler word, no distracting sounds or any frequently used words. Our presiding officer, Raghunath Nair, had three filler words. And our TMOD, Saravanan P, had one repetition, one pause and one filler word. He had quite a few distracting sounds. And our general evaluator, Vyagarajan, had 12 repetitions, 7 pauses, 15 filler words. No distracting sounds as such, and he frequently used the words yes and today. Moving on to our table topic master, Pavitra, she had one repetition and no pauses or filler words. Our speaker one, President Thomas T. Abraham, he had four repetitions, two pauses, one filler word, and he had quite a few voice breaks. And our evaluator one, Renu Narayanan, had two repetitions, two pauses, two filler words, and no distracting sounds. Our speaker two, Lovely Aryan, she had three repetitions, one pause, 9 filler words and no distracting sounds as such. Our evaluator 2, Surya, had 1 repetition and 4 filler words and quite a few voice breaks. Our speaker 3, Rangarajan, had 2 repetitions, 4 pauses and 3 filler words. Our evaluator 3, Sampath Saurirajan, sir, he had 1 pause and 1 filler word. He had distracting sounds, I think, because he was using his mobile. It was quite repeating. Our coming to the TT session, our Toastmaster Narasimhan had no repetitions, 2 pauses and 4 filler words. Toastmaster Abhishek had no repetitions, no pauses and 1 filler word. Toastmaster Sundareshan had no repetitions, no pauses and 2 filler words. Toastmaster Zakir Hussain had 1 repetition, 1 pause and 2 filler words. Toastmaster Shivakrishnan had no repetitions, 1 pause and 3 filler words. Toastmaster Venkateshan had 2 repetitions, 3 pauses and 1 filler word. Toastmaster Sampath had no repetition. No repetition, no pauses and 2 filler words. Toastmaster Alagappan had 2 repetitions, 1 pause and 9 filler words. Toastmaster Lavanya, guest Lavanya had 0 repetitions, 0 pauses, 0 filler words. She had a clean speech. Toastmaster Tilaga, guest Tilaga had 2 repetitions, 1 filler word and 1 pause. Ramesh Rajaviran had 1 pause, 1 pause, 2 filler words and 7 repetitions. Toastmaster Abhinaya had 1 repetition, 0 pauses and 8 filler words. Toastmaster Dinesh had 1 repetition, 1 pause and 3 filler words. That's my report for today. Hope it was clear. I will share it in the group so that you guys can have a better view of it.
And okay.
Yeah. Over to you, General Evaluator.
Okay. Oh, thank you very much, Amita, for the magnificent job you have done. Now, let me move on to Toastmaster Moganasundaram. Yes, let me submit his report as a timer. Yes. What you got to say on the role of your timer?
For the prepared speeches, Toastmaster Thomas Abraham, 14 minutes, 22 seconds. Toastmaster Lovely Aryan, 7 minutes, 20 seconds. Toastmaster Ranga, 7 minutes, 20 seconds. For the table topic speakers, Toastmaster Narasimhan, 1 minute, 10 seconds. Toastmaster Atise, 1 minute, 18 seconds. Toastmaster Sundaresan, 1 minute, 7 seconds. Toastmaster Zakir Hussain, 1 minute, 25 seconds. Toastmaster Sivakrishnan, 1 minute, 15 seconds. Toastmaster Venkateshan, 49 seconds. Toastmaster Sambath, 1 minute. Toastmaster Alagappan, 1 minute 44 seconds. Toastmaster Lavanya Raghu, 1 minute 8 seconds. Guest Tilaga, 1 minute 40 seconds. Guest Ramesh Rajendran, 1 minute 28 seconds. Guest Abhinaya, 1 minute 25 seconds. Toastmaster Dinesh, 1 minute 18 seconds. Under the evaluations, Toastmaster Renu Narayanan, 2 minutes 55 seconds. Toastmaster Surya, 3 minutes 45 seconds. Toastmaster Sambath Saurajan, 2 minutes 56 seconds. Over to General Evaluator.
Yes, is there any time violation? Among the speakers and then TT speakers and then evaluators, any time violation?
All the speakers are qualified
in all the 3 sessions.
For the prepared speeches, Toastmaster Thomas Abraham, Toastmaster Lovely Aryan, and Toastmaster Ranga are qualified. Under the table topics, Toastmaster Venkatesh only disqualified. Under the evaluations, Toastmaster Surya only disqualified.
I see. Okay. Then what about the voting? Voting. Yes. Please. About what about the arrangement for voting?
So the link will the link will be coming to all the Zoom users in a while once it is done. So once the session is done, we will announce the voting to start.
The president, please give me a signal, then I will proceed further.
Sir, now we will have the grammarian giving the report. Thereafter, TMOD will announce the voting, sir. Thank you.
Oh, TMO, okay. Oh, the grammarian, yes. The TMO, okay, okay. Grammarian, I say, grammarian. So, thank you very much, Mr. Thomas. Yes, yes, that is my mistake. Yes. Grammarian, please. That is Jagannathan, please.
Yes, for the grammarian report, I will start from the first. Sharanya used this as the sergeant at arms. She used mutually supportive. It's part of the agenda, Toastmaster agenda, but it sounded good to me, mutually supportive. Guest, when the presiding officer called Tilaga, she used the word enrolling, which is quite famous in corporate nowadays, enrolling in course, this course, that course. So moving on, the presiding officer used the first word he came when you... when he came, is that flabbergasting. I'm sorry, the spelling could be wrong, but then he used this word flabbergasting. The Toastmaster of the day, when he started, used typical, rekindle, antique, when you were talking about the clock, extempore, baptized, which is very good word. He was introducing the GE when he said he was baptized into Toastmasters, and optimism. Phrases used a central theme, whimsical words of wisdom. Feedback is the breakfast of champions. He also used the word of the day once. GE Thyagarajan R, he used the word giddiness, bibliophile, trailblazing. I found the word trailblazing to be very attractive to use. And faces, index of the mind, turbulent waters. Word of the day, the GE used it once. A speaker, Thomas T. Abraham, first speaker, used the words deciphered. I may have noted the word gribe wrong. I don't know whether it's the right word because of the technology. Is it the right word, Thomas?
G-R-I-P-E, gripe.
Gripe, is it? Okay. G-R-I-P-E it is. Yeah. So I will know the meaning and then I'll let the members know. Argumentative, definitiveness, contrarians. It's a noun where people generally oppose or reject the views. Objectivity and dearth. Now, dearth is a word which we generally don't use, which means a lack of. There is a lack of discipline among students. There we say there's a dearth of discipline among students. The phrases sadistic sickness, control and confront, bloated ego. Use this word bloated ego, which means it also means inflated ego. The level of grouch, which I don't know if I've noted it correct or wrong. I will check with him after the offline and then I'll get back to you. When he was disrupted, he used the phrase disruption is part of the menu. There was another intellectual equality. A smoke screen of vagueness, I like this word. When Narasimhan interrupted him, use this word bucketing. So bucketing is when you group people into, that's something new that I heard, when you group people based on certain characteristics. And prejudice is also a word that he used. Speaker 2, Lovely Aryan, used the word metropolitan when she was talking about the cities, perishable, reluctant. Speaker 3, he started off by saying literary correspondence, which to me was an attractive word. Gregarious, timid. Gregarious means sociable. Timid, I means introvert. I'll get back to you on that. And then moving on to the table topics speakers, Narasimhan, he used the word hands which help are better than lips that pray. Now here, pray can also be P-R-E-Y. That also sounds well. And we also used the world of good. Atisha used this word martyred. Sundaresan, this was a very, very placed, very well placed quote from Mark Twain, I believe so. This was from Chanakya. The fragrance of flowers spreads only in the direction of the wind, but the goodness of the person spreads in all directions. Sundaresan, very well, appropriate quote. And Shiva Krishnan used this material possessions. Narasimhan also used the word of the day when he was a table topic speaker. Sampath, Venkat used the word of the day once, although I felt the word of the day was not appropriately used in that context, which we'll have to get back to how we are using the word of the day. Sampath used this success when he finished this table topic. He used this quote, success is not key to happiness, but happiness is the key to success, which I found really good. Speaker 11, Ramesh Rajendran, used this conventional, and he also used open-minded in the phrases. Word of the day, he also used once. Abhinaya used this acquaintance. I may be wrong in the spelling, but she used this word acquaintance. Dinesh used this word daring. Ramesh Rajendran also used the word of the day once. Renu used the word of the day, benign. Surya used the word hassle. DTM Sampath used the word diction when he was talking about the vocabulary of Speaker Rangarajan. And there was a lot of microscopic errors, which I cannot point out in the paucity of time. Numerous microscopic errors, but on the overall, we use this phrase none other than when we are introducing somebody. We can use something else. Now, why should we use none other than if we are going to use it for everybody? It does not make any sense. We also use this phrase nip it in the bud. I have heard it many times. If we can find an alternative, nip it in the bud, that could do well. We also use this peoples when we are starting to learn English, whether we use peoples and children's, that these are words, plural forms, which are not appropriate. People in itself is a plural form. Children in itself is a plural form. Furniture itself is a plural form, not furnitures. And we liberally use this phrase called used to. I used to do this. I used to do that. We'll have to go back to the exact grammatical usage of used to, which I don't know myself. I'll have to get back to when I share this report in the Gmail, I'll get back to you on that. So over to the general evaluator.
Whitey, it was very informative report. Yes. It was a kind of enlightenment for every Toastmaster. Yes. So let me applaud him generously. Now it is my turn. Let me make some observations. This meeting, as usual, is yet another memorable meeting. Nothing to be surprised at in medley Toastmasters. It moves on and moves on. Yeah. It all started at the scheduled hour, and it will conclude at the scheduled time. Yeah. But let me give bouquets to Thomas Abraham and UP Education on this occasion. They deserve some work because they are very receptive for all the suggestions. Why they are such? Absolutely, there is no an iota of ego in their mind. Then only they will be, they such, only such minds will be receptive for suggestions. Yes. So I am very delighted for both of them, both President and the VP. And so let me make a suggestion after making such an observation. See, the contest around the corner. And of course, every medleyan should gear up to participate in the contest. My suggestion is there should be a mock contest before the contest. Yes, that was the case in the earlier days. Yeah, mock contest. That contest should replicate precisely the official contest, or there is no point in holding a mock contest. I made the suggestion in two clubs, CCC, one club, and another is RPTM. Both the presidents accepted it and they also implemented it. Because a mock contest on the eve of official contest will boost the confidence of the freshers. It will be like an elixir. Yes. So my suggestion is please, but I repeat, everything should be replicated as in the official contest. Target speaker, as well as the judges, even prizes. Yes, then only it will incentivize the members. Or else it will not yield any kind of dividends. with this observation, let me conclude my role as general evaluator. Thank you all very much. Signing off is Toastmaster T.R. Tyagarajan.
Thank you, Toastmaster Tyagarajan, for the detailed report from you and your team. With this, we have come to the end of the third session, that is evaluation session. The next one is now on the voting. So you will receive the voting link for the best performers for today. That is speakers, role players, CT speaker, evaluator, and tag player. Please take 20 seconds. Please timer note this 20 seconds and announce when this 20 seconds is over. Timer, are we good with the time? Okay, so we move on to the next section, that is new member induction. So as you know, we have quite a few new members who have joined recently. So this session, we will be inducting them officially into Medley Toastmasters Club. So I would like to invite the following six new members to switch on their camera. One is Toastmaster Pavitra Sridhar, Toastmaster Sundaresan Subramanian, Toastmaster Siva Radhakrishnan, Toastmaster Lavanya Raghu, Toastmaster Sambath Kumar Gunasegan, Toastmaster Abhishek Jain. Please switch on your cameras. Thank you. Membership in Medley Toastmasters Club and in Toastmasters International is a privilege that carries with it many rewards. It also places certain obligations upon you. We are a group of people brought together to do things we could not accomplish alone. Our collective obligation is to grow and improve ourselves and share our knowledge and experience with fellow members in a spirit of enjoyment. We ask you, our new members, to dedicate yourself to personal growth and to help keep this Toastmasters Club strong and dynamic. New members, please listen carefully as I read out the Toastmasters members' promise. In the presence of the members of Toastmasters Club, I promise to attend meetings regularly and prepare fully for each assignment. To apply myself to the program outlined in the Toastmasters manual. To participate actively in club activities. To evaluate others in a positive and constructive manner, to build open, friendly relationships with my fellow members, and to bring other new members to the club so that they can also gain the benefits of Toastmasters. Will you please promise to stand by these obligations?
Yes, I do.
Yes,
yes, me too.
Thank you. I request all Medley Toastmasters to please rise. As Medley Toastmasters, we pledge to support our new members in their quest for self-development, to provide them with positive and helpful evaluations, to maintain a friendly, supportive atmosphere, and to make their Toastmasters membership rewarding and fulfilling experience. Can you please raise your hand? Thank you, fellow members. New members, you will be presented with a welcome ribbon when we reconvene on-premises meeting. With this, we have come to the end of the induction ceremony. Thank you, and I wish you for a very fruitful journey in Toastmasters.
Thank you, Saravanan.
So with this, we have come to the end of this indexes session as well. Now I would give it to the president for taking up to the next one to conclude the proceedings. Over to the president of the day.
Thank you so much, Toastmaster Sharunan. It was really a wonderful meeting, done well with all the role players and all the evaluations and the participants, especially the table topic was really impressive. And one key, one improvement point that I would like to suggest is that we need to get the role players stick to the time and pin the timer so that we can, as we have already done, that we start the meeting on time and we could end the meeting on time as per the schedule. Just a quick reminder that we will be having the evaluation and humorous contest done. Please send the nominations. We also have a few of the members to complete the member survey. So I would, my VP team will get back to you personally so that you could complete it, because it will be a good experience for me, a benign experience for me to schedule and like plan the various role plays according to the needs of the members. And to the new members, one quick announcement is, or information, the September to October fee slots and the role player slots will be released soon. So you could look into having your in your project, the ice-breaking speeches delivered fast. Or if an opportunity comes, we will see how it can be done. The now I would like to have some feedback from the guests. Just Ramesh, you're there. Can I have a feedback on the whole experience?
Yes, sir. Audible, sir?
Yes.
Yes, sir. Today's meeting was really knowledgeable. I was able to learn more of words, phrases, and I'm really a kind of learning. I was happy about that. I got some new words to learn, new ways to present ourselves, and it, as usual, it the role players did a wonderful job. They have pinpointed where we are lacking and they are bridging the gap, and I would really like to appreciate for their efforts. And that is because to become perfectionist, you have to first bridge the gap of enormity. So if you are able to do that, you can lead to the path of perfectionist, and I feel everyone is doing the job. Overall, the meeting was really nice. I was very happy to be a part of it.
Thank you so much, Ramesh. Now, I'm sure you must have gone through the agenda already. We have a surprise session, and to have the surprise session, we have Toastmaster Ishwar. Let me invite Toastmaster Ishwar to do a quick surprise session for everyone. Over to you, Toastmaster Ishwar.
Thank you, Toastmaster Rahul. So this is going to be a really surprise session, but in a way, it is very related to the theme of the day also, the clock that went backward, because we are going to really go backward for this 3 hours, and we are going to see how good each one of our listeners actually, because I'm going to ask a few questions related to the speeches and table topics, a kind of a quiz session. And the least thing I can give is this yummy breakfast, because this is a time for breakfast. Sorry, time for the quick snack actually. So you can imagine having this while you're answering the question, if you are answered right. Or even if not, you can just see this. That is a thing I can. So I would really thank Toastmaster Pavitra, because that really helped me in framing to some of the questions in table topics as well. So just to start with, we'll start with food items itself. So it's the brands she listed, which of them belong to beverages and food items? Can you list any two?
What was the question?
Of the brands which Pavitra listed, which of them belong to beverages and food items?
Coca-Cola. Amul, Coca-Cola.
Bingo.
Amul.
Yeah. Great. Yeah.
McDonald's as well.
Yeah.
McDonald's.
So now increasing the difficulty level a bit. So what are the four communication styles Toastmaster Rangarajan has enlisted in this speech?
Supportive.
Yeah.
Initiative. Analytical.
The last one.
Analytical.
Authoritarian.
No, analytical.
Yeah, there are three. Supportive, initiative, analytical, and the fourth one.
There were only three.
There's a direct.
Three for him.
Yeah. Yes, there's a direct. And now, which is fun-loving? Which communication style is fun-loving? Any guesses?
Supportive?
Supportive.
The other three. It belongs to the other three. It's actually initiative. Supportive is kind of helping others. Initiative is kind of socially relating to the people. I think that's the thing. And another interesting question. So now we had our Thomas Abraham, DTM Thomas Abraham speech. So who are the three interrupters? So that is something, we had three interrupters to his speech.
Ramesh, Raghu, Narasimhan.
Yes. And that's what we have passed on. And yeah. We have in our Toastmaster Lovely speech, so she has mentioned some hazards during this online purchase. One of them is the hidden cost. So which brand gives hidden cost? She has mentioned that. Yeah. Who is that? Who answered it?
Pavitra.
Okay. I thought Lovely. Okay. Yeah. And coming to the Toastmaster session, our Toastmaster Sundaresan has mentioned a quote that is, a fragrance spreads only in the direction of wind, whereas the knowledge spreads in all directions. So which scholar?
Chanakya.
Okay. And okay, then let me go to a bit difficult level of questioning. So we have this in our Toastmaster DTM Thomas Abraham speech. He has mentioned a youngster he met in his journey, which where he mentioned he spent most of his hours in the discussion, and that discussion was encouraging without any levels among the authority. So that youngster worked in which company or which center?
Satish Dhawan Space Center.
Yeah. Satish Dhawan Space is a center. She very good. And how many hours typically they spend on their work?
12 hours.
Because
12 hours, I believe.
Yeah, it's 11 to 12 hours. I think most of them are active listeners. Most of my questions are getting answered very quickly. And another quick question. So in Toastmaster Pavitra's topic, she has mentioned about small mind, average mind, and I think large mind. So what average minds you typically discuss? So one of the topic is related to the mind.
Things.
Things.
Average mind thinks about things.
Yeah, events actually. That's what she mentioned. Average minds discuss about events. And yeah, that's it. So that comes to the surprise session. And I think everyone can have this virtual snacks.
Yeah, thank you so much, Ishu. Yeah. It was like replacement for all the good the chocolates that was given out during the surprise session. Thank you so much. Now we are moving to the what we all are waiting for. Let's get to know who all are the winners of today's prepared speeches and all. Sharanya, can I request you to share the screen, please?
I'm not able to see my screen.
Yes. Yeah. Yes. So, in the meeting. Today's meeting number 581, we have the best speaker, Toastmaster DTM Thomas Abraham. The best table topic speaker, we have three speakers who shared the same thing. It was Toastmaster Abhishek, Gastilaka, and Toastmaster Sakir Hussain. Please put your hats together. It's a wonderful table topic session. And for the best evaluator, we have both Toastmaster Renu and Dr. Sampath Sourirajan sharing the best evaluator role. And now the best role player or the best act player is Toastmaster Jagan. Congratulations. and the best role player, Toastmaster Pavitra, for the table topic session. That was really a great meeting that we had today. Now I take this gavel to close the meeting number 581. Hope you all enjoyed. Looking forward to the next meeting on next Saturday. Now we will have an open session where you can please hang on and we can have an open chat. Let's all unmute and we can have a chat for the session. Though we missed that coffee and snacks in the Gandhi Live Club, let's have a coffee at home and let's have a small chat session. Yes.
So I have a suggestion of all yes. speakers who are all going to deliver speech because they have done so much of work. And because of the limitations of technology, there is a lot of interruption. So okay, before the meeting, we could try delivering the speech to the mentor or the VP ed over Zoom and see if there is a bandwidth issue, because we prepare a lot, but then when we deliver the speech, most of the speech is unheard. And especially Ranga's speech, there were interruptions here and there. Surya's evaluation, there were interruptions. These are important speeches. These are not like table topics.
Exactly. No, I completely agree with you, Jagat, because prepared speeches is like a great, like it gives you a lot of knowledge. And that's what which I look forward in all the prepared speeches, you know, because there's a lot of research going on. Yes, we will have it as one of the...
I'm sorry, Jagan, it's like this. We used to do this. But, you know, when we do the trial, it runs well. Is no proof, no guarantee that when we actually do the speech, it will go well. Technology is like a whimsical, you know, as we say, you know, you cannot predict. That's a whole sad thing about it.
Yes, one thing that we can try is that we can bank on not to do it over Wi-Fi. We can just connect it over LAN. So if it's over LAN, there could be less interruptions when we do it rather than when we do it over Wi-Fi.
Agreed.
It's true. It's true.
That obviously speakers are doing their best within their limitations, which we cannot change. Obviously, they want to do the best.
I am actually connecting with LAN. This is Sampath Suryarajan. I am actually connecting the PC through LAN. But it has got a lot of problem in the last 2 days, the Airtel LAN. So LAN is also not foolproof.
We have guest Abhinaya Tilaka and Bala here. Maybe you can have your views on how you felt on the whole meeting. And just for your information, we have a VP membership. No, I think it is Sharavanan who was the TMOD. We will get back. We'll add you into the group of because so that you are updated on the meeting.
Abhinaya, hi. We didn't have a chance to chat. You are with Ericsson, right?
Yes, Thomas. Okay. Yes.
Okay.
Sure. Yeah. So my experience. So my mentor suggested. I'm very new to Toastmaster. I have not even given my icebreaker speech. So my mentor suggested me to attend. Other Toastmaster meeting as well, and he suggested a medley meeting. So he said you will get a new experience when you attend different meeting, and that will also help you to boost your confidence level. So I feel that is very true after I attend this meeting, and it is well organized, and the table topics are easy to pick up and then to start with. So like a speaker like me, very new to the Toastmaster Club, the topic is very easy to catch up, and then that is very nice.
Good.
So overall it is a wonderful meeting.
So you are not unhappy having joined us in the afternoon?
I'm feeling very happy.
Do it
and
again.
I will participate in every meeting. I will definitely try to participate in every meeting.
The link is the same. That's why I'm saying.
Yeah. So we have the same link, yes. For every meeting.
Yeah. Thank you.
I have a question. Atishay.
Yes,
I heard there was some talk of a contest that's coming up. So what is that? Is that something inside of Medley or something else?
No, we will have the contest for evaluation and humorous speech. There is a criteria which is there. We will let you know. You will have the speech with the contest in the club, and which will then move, the winners will move to the area and then the district.
Often I can assure you, for humor, there is no criterion. You can
pass. Okay, yes, yeah, everyone
can pass. Evaluation, you need to do some levels. So you must now look at humor. In fact, I request you, you will see a link. Tomorrow, there is a very humorous speaker, making a two-hour lesson. Two-hour session. The link is already given in our group. His name is Kishore. He is from Bangalore. He's really hilarious. Do attend.
Sure, definitely.
Are you into humorous speaking, sir? Sundareshan, sir? Are you into humorous speeches?
Well, wish to, but life itself is pretty humor.
No, but you are into serious speaking, I know that. You were only, I was trying to check.
Once I was, even after marriage I was. You have to believe me.
I know.
I have tried it, in recent years, and I haven't tried humor, but why not? Let me fulfill my president's wish also. Let me join in.
Brilliant.
Yes. Is it your annual contest or mock contest or anything?
No, it's annual. In fact, Tyagarajan also will discuss. It's an annual. What we're doing here is, in the first term, in this term, we have two speeches contests, which is evaluation and humor. After 6 months, we will have the prepared speech and the table topics.
Oh. You give a lot of time for the prepared speakers to search and gather and prepare. It's an exciting thing. Good. You can search. Could you please send me the criteria? At the moment, I don't have anything in plan. Let me look into that one. VP Education, Raghu, sir.
Sure.
Yes, sir. Sampath, sir, likes to say something. He is raising his hand.
Hi, sir. Good evening to everyone.
Yes, sir.
Thank you for the opportunity to join this Medley Club. Really, a wonderful experience I had. I attended as a guest for last couple of weeks, but today I joined to this club newly.
Welcome, Sambhav.
Thank you, sir. Thank you for all your support and guidance. And I would like to ask you, how do I start my journey, sir?
We will have a call, Sambhav. We will have a call. I'll speak to you. I'll help you out.
Thank you, sir. Thank you so much. Thank you, everyone.
Yeah.
I suppose all of you have got your mentors?
No, it's on Sampath and one more.
Lavanya has got.
Yeah, Lavanya.
Siva has got.
Yeah, and Sampath and Adishe has to get it.
Okay. Siva has got.
I'll speak to them. I wasn't able to get it.
Broadly, it's like this. Raghu will offer you some mentors. You could make a pick, and then you can start with your first speech, which is a nice break. It's your own life story. So then there's a manual. You will get access to that. And by the way, very happy to introduce Dr. Sampath. He is our coach, our guide for Pathways. Pathways is a new system we started in Toastmasters a couple of years ago. It's a lot more job, workplace oriented than pure speeches. There are 11 parts. You might like to take doctor's help to choose what works best for you.
Okay, sir, noted. Thank you, sir.
And you will get the your Toastmaster number and registration number and details through which you can go in and log in to the Toastmaster website. There will be a list of parts, as Thomas sir said. So you can go through and get it.
Okay, sir. Understood. Right. Thank you, sir.
Thank you.
You're welcome. And I'll speak to you, Sampath. And I'll speak to you.
No problem. Thank you so much.
Any guests we have not been able to connect with?
Bala, I don't know whether he's still there. I see him.
Sampath Saudi Rajan likes to say something. He's raised his hand.
Yes. I'm biding my time because so many people are talking.
Yeah, yes,
I'm going to say something. Like to say something.
Don't bite. Which grab.
Some people, which some people may not agree or may not be happy about. I feel this table topic style is not good. Doing something else, and most people are contriving difficult and different means before bringing the topic. The topic is sometimes quite critical or contrived. I think that should be more simple. And the method of introducing the topics also should be simple. Like you find some brand icon or something like this and then some other topic to another person. I think the whole thing is a farce. This, but I'm not blaming her because she has seen similar things happening before in the last several weeks, if you see. I think we have to think about it a little bit. This is one point. Sure. The second point is, I don't want to discuss that.
I'll speak to you.
Business section of a regular meeting. Sorry? I got something, some serious matter to be raised. So we will see that in the next meeting, if you give me time during the business session, I will raise this topic. It's mainly for the members to participate during the
Sorry, what is that? Doctor, I didn't get that at all. Something for the members. What did you say?
No, I want to raise a move or a proposition for our members to consider. That is, in the next meeting, we have a business session in the beginning or the very end. Should have a business session in which I will introduce that. Then let people think about it. Even a meeting after the next week and make a decision.
Then why don't you please share it with the XCOM? Let's end. We are meeting today. We will. What needs to be done?
I will send one of you.
No. Send it to. You can send me. I will introduce the agenda. And you also correct. That's what we'll do. And the other part, Doctor, I beg to bring to your attention. Each of these people, like Priya, they are trying to make it interesting. And the fact that they've been voted in means the public like these innovations, right? So I think we shouldn't discourage them. You mentioned that as a GE last time. I didn't say anything, but I think we must allow them to make it interesting. They are bringing a little twist.
Twist, yeah. It's a change.
We must let them have it, no? My view, again, is we are a democracy, just my view, Dr. Nothing.
That's good. Yep. Thank you all. It was interesting.
Thank you. Yeah. Bala, you wanted to say something. You want to share the experience, how it was? Or else, let's close the meeting, sir. All right, thank you so much. Let me close the window. We'll see you next week.
We have suits as we have an XCOM meeting happening shortly, right?
Yes.
Ranga, what do we do? How much break do we take for ourselves? No, you're on mute, sir.
I've just sent a message. Can we try and meet at 6 o'clock, or you want to meet earlier, 5:45?
Others are okay. 5:45 we can. Raghu, what's your day?
Should we do it at 6:30?
No, but then somebody will find it very late. No, we wanted to meet.
So go ahead. Let's do it at 6:30.
Six, is it?
6 o'clock.
Yeah, just send a message.
Yeah,
sure.
Yeah, I've already sent a message. If you respond, then we know that we meet.
Okay. Sugandhi wanted to join at 5:30. I'll tell her then to come at 6. Sure.
So, right. Dr. Sambad, we'll wait for your suggestion to be discussed in the XCOM.
So, same link. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay.